Hello, my dear students. So welcome back to our lecture or part two of our chapter four. So or the second part of our chapter four lecture. So let's continue our discussion. So the next topic we're going to discuss is about the expedition of Ferdinand Magellan. Okay. So first, before we discuss about the exploration of Ferdinand Magellan, let us know first, who is Ferdinand Magellan? Okay? So Ferdinand Magellan was born in Sabrosa, Portugal, to a family of minor Portuguese nobility. At the age of 12, Ferdinand Magellan, and his brother Diego traveled to Lisbon to serve as pages at Queen Leonora's court. While at the court, Magellan was exposed to stories of the great Portuguese and Spanish rivalry for sea exploration and dominance over the spice trade in the East Indies, especially the Spice Island or Moluccas in modern Indonesia. Intrigued by the promise of fame and riches, Magellan developed an interest in maritime discovery in those early years. Okay. In 1505, Magellan and his brother were assigned to a Portuguese fleet headed for India. Over the next 7 years, Magellan participated in several expeditions in India and Africa, and was wounded in several battles, of course. In 1513, he joined the enormous 500 ship with 15,000 soldiers force sent by King Manuel to Morocco to challenge the Moroccan governor, who refused to pay its yearly tribute to the Portuguese Empire. The Portuguese easily overwhelmed in the Moroccan forces, and Magellan stayed on in Morocco. So while there he was seriously wounded in a skirmish which left him with a limp for the rest of his life. Okay. So how Magellan served the country of Spain from Portugal? So in 15th century, spices were at the epicenter of the world economy, much like oil is today, so highly valued for flavoring and preserving food, as well as masking the taste of meat gone bad, spices like cinnamon, clove, nutmeg, and especially black pepper were extremely valuable, since spices could not be cultivated in cold in the arid of Europe. No effort spared was this to discover the quickest sea route to the Spice Island. So Portugal and Spain led the competition for early control over this critical commodity. Europeans had reached the Spice Island by sailing east, but none had yet to sail west from Europe to reach the other side of the globe. So Magellan was determined to be the first to do so. So by now an experienced seaman, Magellan approached King Manuel of Portugal to seek his support for the westward voyage to Spice Island. The king refused his petition, okay, repeatedly. So in 1517, a frustrated Magellan renounced his Portuguese nationality and relocated to Spain to seek royal support for his venture. When Magellan arrived in Seville in October 1517, he had no connections and spoke little Spanish. So soon he met another transplanted Portuguese in the name of Diego Barbosa. And within a year, he had married Barbosa's daughter Beatriz, who gave birth to their son Rodrigo a year later. So the well-connected Barbosa family introduced Magellan to officers responsible for Spain's maritime exploration. And soon, Magellan secured an appointment to meet the King of Spain. So, the grandson of King Ferdinand and Queen Isabella, who had funded Christopher Columbus' expedition to the New World, okay, in 1492, received Magellan's petition with the same paper shown by his grandparents. So, just 18 years old at that time, King Charles the First granted his support to Magellan, who in turn promised the young king that his westward sea voyage would bring immeasurable riches to Spain. So, so on August 10, 1519, okay, so on August 10, 1519, that's the time Magellan, what do you call this, started the, what we call, October 1517, started the exploration, okay? Contacted Juan de Aranja, then followed the arrival of his par, Pedro, and with the support of Aranja, they presented their project to the Spanish king, the first future Charles the Fifth. So Magellan's project was particularly interesting since it would open the spice route without damaging relations with the neighboring Portuguese. The idea was in tune with the time. Okay. So in 1519, no? So they started the exploration in 1519. Magellan fleet sailed from Sanlúcar de Barrameda of Spain and crossed the Atlantic Ocean, no? With 5 ships. Okay. So, we have Trinidad, okay, with 55 crews under the command of Ferdinand Magellan. Okay. We have the what we call San Antonio, the ship San Antonio, commanded by Juan de Cartagena. We have Santiago, okay, that commanded by Juan Serrano. We have the ship of Concepcion, commanded by Gaspar de Quesada, and Victoria, commanded by Luis Mendoza. So this is the voyage of Ferdinand Magellan. So the fleet, sabi natin, in September 1519, Magellan fleet sailed from Sanlúcar de Barrameda of Spain and crossed the Atlantic Ocean, which was then known simply as the Ocean Sea. But the fleet reached South America a little more than 1 month later. There, the ship sailed southward, hugging the coast in search of the Fable Strait that would allow passage through the South America in this part. Okay, in this part, in the lowest part, what we call na right now the Strait of Magellan. Okay, so, and the fleet stopped at passage through the South of America. The fleet stopped at Port San Julian, where the crew mutinied on Easter Day in 1520. So Magellan quickly quelled the uprising, executing one of the captains and leaving another mutinous captain behind. Meanwhile, Magellan had sent the ship Santiago to explore the route ahead, where it was shipwrecked during the terrible storm. So the ship crew members were rescued and assigned out among the remaining ships. With those disastrous events behind them, the fleet left Port San Julian 5 months later when a fierce seasonal storm abated. Okay. On October 21, 1520, Magellan finally entered the Strait, what we called that, before they called it, named it Strait of All Saints, because during that time, that is the time of what you call this, or the Peace of All Saints. Kaya tinawag ito na Strait of All Saints, no? But in honor to Ferdinand Magellan, who discovered this particular strait or sea route that connects the Atlantic Ocean and the Pacific Ocean, no? Then pinangalan sa kanyang strait na to, and we now we call it as Strait of Ferdinand or Strait of Magellan. So the voyage through the Strait of Magellan was treacherous and cold, no? And many sailors continue to mistrust their leader and gamble around the danger of the journey ahead. In the early days of the navigation of the strait, the crew of San Antonio forced its captain to desert, and the ship turned and fled across the Atlantic Ocean back to Spain. At this point, only 3 of the original 5 ships remained in the fleet. So nawala na si Santiago, nawala na si San Antonio. Okay, 3 na lang ang nasira kasi sa Santiago, so 3 na lang ang natira sa kanila. Sino-sino yon? Anong mga barko yon? We have Trinidad, Concepcion, and the ship of Victoria. Okay, so after more than a month spent traversing the strait, no, actually their experience during that time in that particular part of South America na sobrang labig, so nagugutom na, kaya nang mga nagkakaroon ng pagkakagulo or nagkakaroon ng mutiny, it is because of their experience, their lot of hunger, no. Sabi nga sa ibang libro, yung mga sodas, no, yung sodas, siya mismo yung ginagawang harina as flour to make breads, okay? What else? Yung mga dagana na nahuhuli daw nila, nahuhuli according to some historians, doon sa barko nila, yun yung ginagawa na nilang karne. So, ganun na ka-terrible yung experiences nila during that particular exploration na nangyayari during the time of Ferdinand Magellan exploration. So, but more than a month spent traversing the strait, Magellan remaining armada emerged in November 20 to behold a vast ocean before them. They were the first known Europeans to see the great ocean, which Magellan named it Mar Pacifico or the Pacific Ocean, for its apparent peacefulness, a stark contrast to the dangerous water of the strait from which he had just emerged. Okay? In fact, extremely rough water are not uncommon in the Pacific Ocean. We all know that, where tsunamis, typhoons, and hurricanes have done serious damage to the Pacific Island and Pacific Rim nations throughout history. Okay. Little was known about the geography beyond the South America during that time, and Magellan optimistically estimated that the trip across the Pacific would be rapid. In fact, okay, it took 3 months for the fleet to make its way slowly across the vast Mar Pacifico. The days dragged on as Magellan's crews anxiously waited to utter the magic word, land ho. Okay, at last the fleet reached the Pacific island of Guam. No, when they reached the island of Guam in the Pacific Ocean, they named, because of many sailboats, they named it Island of Sailboats. Okay? Sabi na, Island of Sailboats. Okay? Kasi nakita na, ang daming, yung mga natives doon, pagkita nila sa isla, no? Na ano pa sila, natuwa sila. But before they reached the Guam, meron pa silang island na nakita na island na walang tumutubo na kahit anumang halaman, at they called it as, or they named it as Unfortunate Island, kasi kahit isang halaman walang tumutubo. Okay? When the next island they reach in the Pacific Ocean is the Island of Guam. They named it Island of Sailboats, kasi nakita nila dami-dami mga sailboats. There are a lot of sailboats in the island. So they named it as Island of Sailboats. No? So, sinalubong sila ngayon, no? They met the natives in Guam. And akala nila, okay, binigyan sila ng pagkain. In return, na in exchange of their baluti, yung mga dress nila, yung mga gold nilang suot, yung mga excess nilang mga sword or weapons, no? In exchange of that, nakuha sila mga tubig, pagkain nila, or resources, or yung food nila. Okay? So, habang nagpapahinga sila, when they are resting in the island, no? They discovered that some of the natives go to their ship at ninanako yung kanilang mga gamit. So, dali-dali, umalis sila, Ferdinand Magellan, umalis sila. No?
Nung umalis sila doon sa Guam, no, bago sila umalis, change nila yung pangalan doon sa island na yon, at tinawag nila ito na the Islands of Thieves o isla ng mga magnanakaw. So they continue the exploration pa westward, no? And until they saw the island of Samar and Leyte. Okay, that is the sign. Okay? So ito, this is the timeline of expedition of Ferdinand Magellan. Okay? About this one. Okay? So I already discussed to you this, no? Okay, this one. Sabi nga natin, and on March, on the month of March, they saw the what we call Island of Samar and Leyte, and Magellan named it as the Islas de San Lazaro, of Island of Saint Lazarus. Because during that time, is the Feast of Saint Lazarus. So doon niya pinangalan yung isla ng nang nakita niya yung isla ng Samar and Leyte. And they continue the exploration. Okay? They continue the exploration. Okay? And they reach the Homonhon Island. So, when they were in the Homonhon Island, okay? When they were in the Homonhon Island, nagulat yung mga Pilipino. The Filipinos were shocked. No? Yung shock nila, hindi natakot, kundi naawa. No? Naawa sila sa lagay nila Ferdinand Magellan. Bakit sila naawa sa lagay ni Ferdinand Magellan, guys? Kasi nakita nila ang papaya. No, what do you, as you imagine yung kanilang hirap, no, kung hindi ka masyadong nakakain, of course, papayat ka. And since we are very hospitable, okay, one of the characteristic of Filipinos is very hospitable. Ang ginawa ng mga Pilipino, sinalubong sila, doon pa lang sila sa Pampang, sinalubong sila. At pinigyan agad, or the Filipinos gave them food and water. No? At wala yung exchange, wala silang binigyan na exchange doon. Kundi kung ano lang yung meron sila. Okay? At tinulungan sila ng mga natives sa Homonhon Island. No? So, when they already nakapagpahinga na sa Homonhon Island, okay, they reach the Limasawa Island. Okay? Actually, there is on March 28, what we call this issue. Saan nga ba unang pumunta talaga si Ferdinand Magellan? Is it in Limasawa or Masao in Agusan del Norte? So, but according to our history, Magellan reached Limasawa. So, let's discuss that particular issue separately after this discussion. So, the first month, and in March 31, the first month was the first month happened in the Philippines in the island of Limasawa. Okay. So, when Magellan, no, reached the Limasawa, syempre, nung nakapunta sila sa Limasawa, they converted some of the natives there into Catholics or Christians, no, and they transferred to Island of Cebu. Okay? Where the first mass baptism in the Philippines, yung pinakamalaking baptism kasi, first mass baptism in the Philippines happened in the Philippines, in the Island of Cebu. Okay? So, anong kinalaman ng Cebu, sir? Because during that time, Cebu was headed by its chieftain, Raja Humabon. So, dahil nga very hospitable tayo, no? Ang ginawa ni Ferdinand Magellan, no? Sobrang bait naman ng mga to, no? Sabi natin, sobrang bait naman ng mga to. So, ginawa ni Ferdinand Magellan is that they, ginawa nila Raja Humabon is that they were persuaded by Ferdinand Magellan to become Catholic or Christians. So they agreed and they baptized, no? And during that time, no, as a gift, Ferdinand Magellan gave a small image of Child Jesus to the wife of Raja Humabon, which is Doña Juana. So he gave the small Child Jesus or the black Santo Niño. But actually, according to history, hindi siya totally black. No, may nangyari kasi bakit siya daw nangitim. Okay? So, meanwhile, while Magellan was in Cebu, a quarrel broken out between the two rival chieftains nearby island of Mactan. Okay? Between Raja Sula and Raja Lapu-Lapu. Okay? So, Raja Sula, he wanted kasi na to govern the whole island of Mactan. But actually, Mactan was divided into two parts, no? We have another part is from ruled by Sula and Lapu-Lapu. So hindi nagkasundo si Raja Lapu-Lapu at sa Sula. So Sula went to Cebu to seek Magellan's help to fight against Lapu-Lapu. And according to history nga, sabi ng ibang libro, sinasabi nila doon, itong si Raja Sula sinrana ito si Ferdinand Magellan, si Lapu-Lapu kay Ferdinand Magellan. No? Kaya nagalit naman itong si Ferdinand Magellan. That's the reason why Magellan sent, no, or sailed with his army to Mactan on April 27, 2021. Naganap itinatag nating battle in Mactan. Okay, so what happened here in the battle of Mactan? Actually, sabi nga sa kasaysayan, it's not Lapu-Lapu who killed directly Magellan, but one of the soldier of Raja Lapu-Lapu. So, paumaga pa lang yun, no? And the soldiers of Raja Lapu-Lapu were ready to fight during that time. Dahil nga umaga, no, we have the natural phenomena na low tide. So, in this part of Mactan Island, no, nung pumasok na ito sila Ferdinand Magellan, they were not able to reach near in the island. So sobrang layo nila kasi nga sumasayad na yung barko. So they don't have a choice but what? To go on the sea para maglakad going to the seashores. Papunta dun sa mismong isla ng Mactan. But surprisingly, no, Magellan, Lapu-Lapu and his troops, no, ay naandun na mismo sa may seashores, nakaabang na. At nagpaulan na agad ng mga palasong may lason. Okay? Siyempre, dahil nga alam naman natin nung damit or suot ng mga Spaniards before, syempre may mga baluto sila. What do you expect? Sobrang bigat ng mga damit nila or dala nila. Mga metals kasi usually yung mga baluti nila eh. Okay? So dahil doon, no, nahirapan silang maglakad, correct, maglakad sa dagat, papunta sa Pampang. Ibig sabihin, basa na yung gamit nila, ang hirap na hirap sila. So anong ginawa ngayon ni Ferdinand? Anong ngayon ang nangyari kay Ferdinand Magellan? No? Naunahan sila ng tropa nila Lapu-Lapu. No? Ano yung mga factors kaya bakit natalo siya ang grupo ni Ferdinand Magellan here in the Battle of Mactan? Kasi una, lack of knowledge about the geographical features or geographical location ng island of Mactan. Okay? Pangalawa, no? Sabi natin, they are not ready. Kasi na-surprise sila na ang dami palang tauhan nito ni Ferdinand, ani Raja Lapu-Lapu. Diba? So sobrang dami ng tauhan ni Raja Lapu-Lapu. No? More than the tauhan ni Ferdinand Magellan, na talo ito sila Ferdinand Magellan, but not Lapu-Lapu who killed directly Magellan, but one of the soldiers of Rahalapu-Lapu.
So the survivors of the what we call Bactan in the Bactan Mate battle went back to Cebu. They went back to Raha Humabon. So pagdating nila dun sa island of Cebu, okay, when they went back to Cebu, nagulat sila na they were invited by Raha Humabon to attend a party. Akala nila welcome back party, yung welcome party again. So nagpahanda si Raha Humabon, no? Naghanda itong si Raha Humabon, nagpa-party, nagbigay ng mga alalak, no, pagkain. Okay? But may plano na pala that time si Raha Humabon. So habang kumakain sila, habang nag-uminsa ng alak, nilasing talaga nila yung ibang Spaniards, yung iba na matay na sa lason kasi nilagyan ng poison nila Raha Humabon yung mga food and drinks nila Raha ng mga Espanyol. Okay, bakit kaya ginawa niya ni Raha Humabon? Okay? Why Raha Humabon did it or did that? Because it is because okay, it is because when he discovered, no, yung Malay Islig ni President Magellan ay nagsalita or nagsumbong kay Raha Humabon, no, na itong mga Espanyol na to ay may mga nirip silang mga Cebuana. Okay? And aside from that, they went doon sa mga burial caves in Cebu at kinuha nila yung mga bangkay, gamit ng mga bangkay. Eh, during that time, when yung mga Espanyol na yun, nagulat kasi sa nakita nila sa loob ng kuweba ng mga ng Cebu. Ano nakita nila doon? Lots of gold. May ngipin na ginto, mga necklace, no? Kasi this is the our custom. As we remember our discussion about the early ancestors, kung paano natin iburol o ilibing yung mga labi na mga sinaunang ancestors natin, no? Pinapabauna natin sila ng mga ginto. At doon nasilaw ang mga Espanyol. Kaya naman nila nagawa, no? Na nakawin ang mga gamit doon sa loob ng kuweba or gamit ng mga namayapang ancestor natin sa loob ng kuweba. Okay? So, sabi natin, dahil doon, no, itong mga survivors na to, no, doon sa ginawa na yun ni Raha Humabon, no, konti na lang sila. They plan to go back in Spain, no? So, tatlong barko yun, di ba? We had Concepcion, Victoria, and Trinidad. Si Concepcion, dahil nga wala nang mag-ano sa kanya, wala nang magmamandate, at sabi nila, medyo sira na itong barkong to, sinunog na lang nila yung barko, kasi nga, kaya nila sinunog itong barko nito para hindi na magamit ang mga natives na Cebuanos. Baka kasi inisip nila, baka sundan pa sila. So, itong barko ng Victoria and Trinidad ship left Cebu, no? And they decided that to go back to Spain, no? Gamit, yung una, yung isa, dediretso na, yung Victoria, ang napag-usapan nila, si Victoria ship will continue the exploration going back to Cebu, no? Going back to Spain, and another, the Trinidad ship will go back, no, to Spain using the route they used, no, with Magellan nung papunta pa lang sila sa Pilipinas. Okay? But unfortunately, when they were in the south of the Philippines, no, southern part of the Philippines, no, etong si Victoria ship, sinasabi sa kasaysayan, this ship reached the Moluccas Island. And advantage yun sa mga Espanyol. Okay? And they went back to Spain with Sebastian L. Cano. Sebastian de L. Cano. So, this Trinidad ship, anong nangyari? They were captured by the Portuguese. Okay? When they were captured by Portuguese, according to some historians, when they were captured by Portuguese, sobrang brutal yung ginawa sa kanila. Kinukuha yung kuko, no? Inaalis yung kuko ng buhay sila. Binabalatan sila ng buhay. Ganun ka-harsh ang mga Portuguese. And some historians said that, no, mas swerte pa rin ang mga Pilipino na Espanyol ang
ang nakadiscover sa atin at hindi talaga Portuguese. Kasi sobrang daw brutal, na, sabi ng mga some historians, sobrang brutal ng mga Portuguese compared sa mga Espanyol. Okay? So, again, Victoria ship was the one who was able to return to Spain with Sebastian de Elcano as their captain. And ano ngayon ang nangyari? No, when they went back to Spain, of course, Sebastian Elcano reported the events happened during the expedition with Ferdinand Magellan and how Magellan was killed in the island of Cebu. Sabi ngayon, kinuwento ngayon ni Sebastian Elcano, may nakita kaming isla sa ganitong sa silangang pahagi na ito na kung saan itong islang ito ay very rich in gold. Okay? Nagka-idea ngayon at itong isang ito ay malapit sa tinatawag natin na Spice Island at narating din namin ang Spice Island. So when they reported it to the King of Spain, nagkaroon ngayon ang idea ng King of Spain to send another expedition. Okay? And again, Sebastian Elcano is the one and some of the soldiers na kasama ni Sebastian Elcano, dahil nga si Sebastian Elcano ang leader ng ship na nakabalik, sa siya yung talagang nakapag-circumnavigate in the what? In the whole world. But ino-honor si Ferdinand Magellan. Bakit? Bakit sinasabing who discovered the earth is round? Sabi nila Ferdinand Magellan. Why? Because during that time Magellan is the what? Yes, very good. The cap or the leader of that particular expedition. So in honor to him, no, kaya sinasabi ng some historians na siya ang nakadiscover na ang mundo ay bilog. Or he proved that the earth is round. Again, kasi nga sabi nila, akala nila, no, the idea is that akala nila the earth is flat. Okay? But Ferdinand Magellan expedition proved that the earth is round. Okay? So what happened, no, when the King of Spain learned about this particular events, no, na nangyari sa expedition ni Ferdinand Magellan. Ano kaya ang ginawa ni King of Spain? Yan yung tatalakayin natin sa mga susunod pa natin o part 3 ng ating chapter 4 na lecture. Again, I'm going to